When you're in a situation where you don't know whether to be happy or to cry, Na-kyum, you must make your own choices, and yet he chose to be with Seung-ho. Does your heart also melt in this beauty? Seung-ho is acting tough in front of his father, but only Na-kyum can see his vulnerable side. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more Yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my social media at ZEALED FUJOSHI, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more Yaoi content. If that's something that interests you, feel free to follow me at ZEALED FUJOSHI. Finally, this episode will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into chapter 87 of Painter of the Night. Seung-ho snapped at his father and introduced Daddy Yoon to Na-kyum. I believe Seung-ho kissing Na-kyum in front of his father was to show him that he will do anything to Na-kyum to keep Na-kyum by his side, and also declaring war against his father. But in all seriousness though, Seung-ho is going a little bit mad in this chapter, and I think he really has cracked. He's putting up this big show in front of Daddy Yoon, and he doesn't want his dad to see how much of an effect his dad had on him over these years. And we see that right after Daddy Yoon leaves the room. And then Na-kyum starts comforting Seung-ho. Seung-ho is struggling and Na-kyum can't do anything else aside hugging him. And I screamed at this part of this chapter because seeing Seung-ho take away his mask and Na-kyum hugging him when he does it, it's just such a beautiful chapter. Because it's basically Na-kyum deciding to stay on Seung-ho's side for good sake. It's difficult to embrace other people's trauma, and we clearly see it here in this chapter when Na-kyum basically stays for Seung-ho. And it's okay if you can't understand people's trauma. There's nothing selfish about it. Embracing it can look toxic sometimes, but not always. If there's an understanding between two people and people can just move past their differences, you know, embracing someone's traumatic past and their toxic present can also be beautiful, as we see this chapter. Like, we've always said how Na-kyum should just run away, because yeah, that's the easy way. Running away can be, but Na-kyum is so in love with Seung-ho that his love can actually save Seung-ho, and we know that Na-kyum wishes will change, and we know it's not gonna be easy. But in this chapter, we basically see Na-kyum stating that he can fix it. Our pure and naive Na-kyum is starting to slowly lose his naive, and he saw how cruel Daddy Yoon was. Uh-huh. And life was so different for Na-kyum. He had so many nunas that loved him and wish him a bright and beautiful future. So he doesn't understand how Seung-ho's dad can be so cruel to his own son. But we all know Painter of the Night is not over yet, so we know the cruel reality that we're 100% sure that Daddy Yoon will make sure that Na-kyum will understand how cruel it is to be part of the world. But the parallels of Seung-ho and Na-kyum's childhood. Na-kyum, who grew up in a Kiseng house but was given so much love and affection and was taught the self-value of a human being. Meanwhile, Seung-ho, who grew up abused and alone in a noble house, he had everything a lot of people wishes they had, but you know, he wasn't loved. He was all alone. And the end, he really needs a lot of heat, and he will be able to start loving Na-kyum properly once he starts healing. And in this chapter, it's very saddening to see that at a very young age, Seung-ho experienced something that traumatized him for the rest of his life. And this is the reason why he's not expecting anyone to save him at all. We all wish, or at least majority of us wishes, that our Lord will heal. But a lot of us also wishes that it won't be at the expense of me. And part of me thinks that, yes, go see your calligrapher, yes, but hopefully after that, you guys should re-talk things out. And if you're a little bit confused about this story about the calligrapher, there is a story that Korea, if you go see a calligrapher, he will quote-unquote write you a beautiful or lucky future. And it is a tradition in old Korea that it's very common if you're about to marry someone or you're about to have kids, because if you go see the calligrapher to buy your commission art to hang in your wall, now it could be a beautiful painting or a beautiful quote or a word that would mark as an inspiration for your life, or a lucky word or phrase that can start off your new year, or anything that, you know, is significant that could really change your life. So, you know, it really means a lot when, you know, Na-kyum finally agreed to see this calligrapher. It's a good way to start their life, that Na-kyum is gonna stay with Seung-ho, that he's not gonna go away anymore, that for them to get the red. So Na-kyum is looking forward to his life with Seung-ho. But I am gonna call it now though, with all that's happening past the chapter. It's almost really obvious now that one of them, and I'm willing to bet that it's probably Seung-ho, is about to die. I know it's really grim, and I know I've told this a couple of chapters ago that the ending of Painter of the Night might be bittersweet. Don't get me wrong though, I really wish that there's gonna be a happy ending for this series, but there seems to be a lot of foreshadowing that's going on, and I kind of feel like with what's going on in chapter 87, I feel like he might actually die protecting Na-kyum or something like that. Maybe the only way I can see Na-kyum and Seung-ho be happy in this era is if they run away right now, chapter 87, and start a life somewhere far away from all the Yoon family bullshit. And then that's how we are able to get a happy ending. But as long as they stay in this neighborhood where they are within reach of the Yoon family, I really don't think that they're gonna have a happy ending that we hope they will get. Because the world is very cruel for our baby. But don't get me wrong, I'm still hoping for a happy ending. And I'm really hoping that together they go to the calligrapher in springtime when the weather is nice, and it all ends there. That could be an ending too. It just ends there. Like, we don't have to see all of the planning that Min is thinking of and what Daddy Yoon is planning. All of the suffering that all of these harsh men is about to drop on Seung-ho and I. You can just end it there when they go to the calligrapher in spring. Just end it there. Or they can just run away. Those are two options that we can get our happy ending. But realistically, as long as they stay in this neighborhood or in Korea, they can run off to China if they so chose to. As long as they stay in this neighborhood, I don't see a happy ending. Deep inside, I'm hoping that no one will die. Because it's really tragic to live alone when the person that you love the most died. I still believe that both of them deserves a happy ending. I know I'm being a little bit dramatic, but you know that what I'm saying is a possible future for them too. And knowing how Byeonduck is staying true to as realistic as she could be, I really don't see a happy ending as long as they stay in. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me in my Discord channel. I'd love to hear back from you. And please consider supporting the show by donating as little as 99 cents through www.zealedfujoshi.xyz. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manwha details can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.